First of all, you released your Q4 figures for last year. The growth was particularly strong in enterprise and partner business. So I just wanted to get your thoughts on, potentially in the past, service providers might have seen you as competitors, but now you're potentially a very strong ally.
Yeah, so I think, you know, our go-to-market strategy has always been around a multi-channel partner and distribution capabilities, and also being directly in touch with the customers. And the beauty of the service provider distribution channel for us is that we bring a lot of expertise of direct customer contact for a set of applications and services that a lot of carriers have somewhat abstracted themselves from. So we bring real-world use cases, the ability to solve those issues, and this is a great forum here at CloudComm Summit to have those discussions and be able to present ourselves as a solution provider, both for the service providers and as a direct provider ourselves.
What do you think is the most challenging, or I suppose the biggest area of opportunity in terms of that shift, in how service providers see you within the industry? Because undoubtedly, I've been at certain events where people are told to be wary of the threat from the over-the-top provider. So that must be something you're conscious of in terms of rectifying.
And sure, and that position that service providers take, they're well accustomed to that threat. You know, you had an app like WhatsApp that came into the marketplace and erased $100 million in service revenues in 1 month. So that's a very scary proposition to the service provider. I think what we do differently is we come in and say, look, as much as the world has quote unquote shifted away from voice, we see voice and all these other transaction types still being fundamental to the enterprise. But they have to be packaged in an all-inclusive app. They have to be wrapped in messaging. They have to have an open platform around them. They have to have an AI. When you start layering application and application and application, and notice my word here being application, around that, that's where service providers really need help from companies like RingCentral.
The main theme of the event this year at CloudComm Summit is innovation, and I know that's something that's incredibly important for you guys at RingCentral. You spend a large proportion on research and development. And obviously that's critical, isn't it, for enabling those service providers to process those applications?
Absolutely. So at RingCentral, innovation is front and center with the company. It's part of the core culture. On one hand, we can talk, you know, how much we spend on innovation. So last year we spent over $100 million just on the RingCentral platform. That is a significant amount of money, a lot more than even several of our competitors combined. And we're going to spend more than that this year. Now, great quote on the screen earlier this morning. It's not about how much money you spend. It's also about your culture. I've been with the company for over 9 years, and the culture there is disruptive and innovative. It's speed, speed, speed. 4 to 6 major releases a year, releases in between those releases, constant evolution of the product. One of my favorite phrases that we hear from the sales team and other people that we've used, you know, in the marketplace here is, what I sell you today and what you install tomorrow will be the worst product you've ever had from RingCentral. It'll only get better.